What safer space is there for a Democrat to go to than one of the late night shows with the non-comedic folks that run those late night shows like Stephen Colbert, right? Well, that's where Kamala Harris went recently. Watch this.
Well, I have the great privilege of serving with Joe Biden, who was president of the United States. Exactly right. And was vice president, right?
Does that affect it? Does he understand what it's like to be a vice president?
He does. And he really is a true partner, and he understands the job. And remember, we came in during the height of the pandemic.
Yes.
And so much of the work was about, okay, we've got to cover a lot of bases, and let's figure out how between us we can do it.
And I have the great pleasure of working here at Real America's Voice, and I get to deal with people like my buddy Ed Henry and Karen in the morning. They're just so great, and they worked at other TV places too. What in the world is her body language saying with all this ridiculous stuff? I don't know, but I know somebody who does. It's our body language expert, former military interrogator, he's a behavior expert. Greg Hartley is with us. You can find more about Greg at his website, readbodylanguage.com. Greg, welcome.
Thanks, Grant. Happy to be here. I'll tell you something your body language didn't do that hers did.
Yeah.
Is it didn't show discomfort. When she first started and she said, I have the pleasure of being with the president, notice her arm is across her abdomen. And if you'll pay attention to that, men, when we stand in front of a crowd and we're uncomfortable, we put our hand in front of our groin. We're protecting primary sex organs. When a woman crosses her abdomen, she's doing the same thing. And it's instinctive. It's part of the animal. It's what keeps us reproductive.
That's hilarious. So I got to watch that when I go out on stage. I know the baseball players like to do that. I'm not sure they're protecting anything. They're giving it a little scratch or something. But so she she is literally protecting, huh? That's what's happening there.
Yeah, watch her arm is across her body, and she's gripping her wrist. And one of my partners on the behavior panel, Mark Bowden, would say that is joint protecting, the most important thing in our body. She'll do that until she hears that uproarious laughter, and then her hands come up, and she goes on to message.
All right, so as we keep running it here, and then she clasps her hands, she does all kinds of stuff. They're nonstop moving, and she's not Italian, so I can't give her that. I am half Italian. I like to use my hands. She's not. So what's up with all the hand movement?
Well, she's ready. She's doing a telegraphed speech. She came in there to deliver this message. Once she realizes they're going to accept it, you see her hands moving and punctuating what she's thinking. More importantly, listen to that pause, that pregnant pause, intentionally for effect, after she says, we came in the middle of the pandemic, beat, 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 and then she starts talking again. That's for effect. All of that is to deliver a certain message. You can tell that she feels okay with it. Then when she gets down to Biden, and she's shaking her head no, and she's saying Biden was a good vice president. What she means by that, you can see that's just positive reinforcement of what she's saying. You have no idea. And the way you know that is her punctuation with her words, with her phrases, with her hands, with all of that go together. So she's feeling positive because she's on friendly ground.